Hello and welcome to The German Guy Reviews. I'm The German Guy. I almost didn't make this review because I thought Ballermann 6 was the last one. It was by sheer coincidence that I found out that this was a trilogy. The failed brain surgery trilogy. This is why we put numbers after the movie, people. Or at least make secondary titles. Anyway, a quick recap, shall we? There are these two idiots, Tommy and Mario, who do loads of stupid bullshit and try to rape a woman once. And this became an instant movie classic here in Germany. You know, usually I get very offended when in a story about, say, World War I, we Germans still get painted as the bad guys, as the nation of evil, even though the morality of it all was much more grey area, but seeing this kind of stuff makes me think that maybe people do have a point after all. We start off by seeing that after their many years as professional idiots, Tommy and Mario decided to become cops. I have no way to prove this at this moment as I write this part in the review. I haven't really started watching the film yet, but I bet my organs and life insurance that they did so in order to take drugs. We really kick off the story by watching our two morons watching a scam show on TV. Where, when you call and pay 10 euros per minute, you can win 500 euros in return. After you waited for 2 hours, of course. And the obvious answers you give will be declared wrong because of some phony loophole. Suffice it to say that these kind of shows have been under legal scrutiny for years now. Because our two walking human waste bins have serious listening problems, like, for example, when a woman says no, they don't hear the robot voice on the other end say that all lines are busy right now. And they wouldn't have won anything anyway because the answer was wrong. But whatever, they start to party like the attention deficit hyperactivity children who are drunk that they are. You know, sometimes I feel like I'm a little bit too aggressive and dehumanizing. But then I remember these are worthless degenerates and nobody would miss them if they died. By the way, Tom Gerhardt and his colleague Hilmir Sölzer, who plays Mario, who I haven't seen in anything else since this thing came out, look so very old and tired. Like, when nature itself is telling you it's time to stop, you should maybe listen. Also, I'm trying not to make fun of their outfits, but never before was the line the 90s called more appropriate. I mean, there are many people who can wear a certain outfit and make it work, even when they hit their 40s or 50s. But it just looks so out of place here. Like, they have seriously outgrown this. It's the same feeling you get when you see Dumb and Dumber 2, another sequel that came out way too many years late and nobody wanted and nobody needed. The two main leads have been already in much greater, more prestigious things and are now forced back to play a role that would have made sense to play when they were still in that time period. The age difference makes it all the more pathetic. I mean, when I first heard recently that they were going to make another Jackass movie, my first thought wasn't, oh, this is kind of cool. I thought,
cowabunga, dudes.
Imagine for a second they made a Titanic remake, because I don't see Titanic 2 happening, even though I saw people try, and they would cast Leonardo DiCaprio for the same role again. The young, twinkly-eyed character doesn't fit him anymore at this point, does it? And this is how it feels like. It's like as if at the end of Avengers Endgame, Steve Rogers went on to remain Captain America. There is a time and a place, and your time is over, man. Not like sitting on a comfy couch and complaining about media. That you can do for all eternity, even if you are just a head in a jar. They throw rounds for the entire bar, spending way more money than they even would have won on TV, and have to walk the painful way to their jobs as cops the next morning. Well, on the plus side, at least they are out of their old clothes. They get in the car while they are still drunk and naturally ruin it. Says the anarchist, nice, they are doing my work for me. I also first was gonna say that my suspension of disbelief is broken because I can't imagine that these two would ever be allowed to become police officers. But then I remembered that in 2017, over 200 policemen from Hamburg who were asked to keep the G20 summit safe were sent home because they were too drunk. I think with that little story you can see the difference between German and American police. Our police are like a cool dad who hires a stripper for your birthday. Yours are like paramilitary bouncers with PTSD. They then try to enforce the law, but that goes as well as you expected. Haha, the classics never die. They simply refuse to die. Guess the writer wanted to get that running gag out of the way so we can move on to more, exciting things? We go back 3 months in time and we learn how it came to be that Tommy and his best buddy wanted to become cops. Because of what else? Da womans. And all of a sudden I do wish police officers were more brutal and trigger happy here. Then back in the present we see some horrendous abuse of authority and power. But the movie does add something very nicely. Some good old justice and consequences. Mario and Tommy are being ordered to patrol the street in front of the police station so that the commissioner can always have an eye on them and can make sure that they won't do stupid crap anymore.
Not gonna happen! No, not gonna happen! Not gonna happen!
And I'm right, obviously. Instead of starting some self-reflection, Mario and Tommy blame the police officer who snitched on them. Who admittedly is a prick, but all he did was to write a letter to the commissioner telling him of what they did. They decide to go to the zoo and send an angry animal at him. You know, a story about a serial killing policeman sounds fresh and interesting. Why has nobody ever done that before? Probably because there are literally hundreds of such stories, but I can't think of any right now.
Special Officer Doofy reporting.
Anyway, the next day their plan works and the other guy gets torn to shreds, but also the commissioner who happens to drive with him. They immediately suspect our two substitute heroes but have no evidence. But who cares? There are far greater issues of importance. Like for example, the gold mascot of a football team they like got stolen. And without it, how they are going to win the big game? Just buy a new one like every parent does with a pet? And if you need good luck so badly, just, I don't know, take a few rabbit paws, grind them up and use them as sunscreen? God, I messed up. Detective Tommy and Mario are on the case, by which I mean they rather watch some naked cheerleaders under the shower. You have the internet, right? I mean this overtly horny type of character with an exploding libido really doesn't make any sense anymore. Unless you really do live in some backwater far away from civilization town. In which case, oh boys, you are in for a treat. They almost kill the only lead they have, but the information they got is not enough so that they could continue the investigation. Not that they are smart enough to find the thief, even if they had a photograph, name and address. They decide to steal some clothes from a surgeon, and you know where this is going. I'd rather have Dr. Steinman do a facelift on me. There is one legit funny scene where the woman whose dog got murdered in the first and second movie returns, visiting the psychiatrist because she fears that Tommy and Mario are some sort of lunatics who follow her and kill her pets on purpose. When she gets talked out of her fear, of course, tragedy strikes again. The essence of this whole ordeal is that some guy with wart on his ass is the culprit. The muscle-packed douchebag from the very first movie makes a comeback as well, and Tommy and Mario find an excuse to take the guy's car keys. So, if they remember that this minor character exists, does that mean the mafia is also coming back? The two officers, I can't believe I'm saying this, begin to think and get some ideas who could be responsible, but they also realize that they are going to need some weapons to take them on. Probably because A, they won't give you weapons, or B, you have them but you don't know how to turn off the safety. No, actually, theirs got taken away after they have been degraded. We get another, I can't believe I am saying this either, genuinely funny scene. Where they get some equipment from a paranoid store clerk, the kind of guy that dares to ask the question, why should I not own weapon-grade plutonium? They accidentally use some pepper spray on a woman. Weird, usually this must be the other way around. Pepper spray, which is from the KGB, which this guy just happens to have. I don't even want to know in what brutal corners of the dark web this guy is dwelling in. And then hilarity ensues. Meanwhile, the prick officer is on a quest for revenge. And he fails. Okay, good that we cleared that up. Also, this is a very interesting new interpretation of the Phantom of the Opera. They crash the car in the most awesome way that I have seen in a long time, and they are forced to downgrade their vehicle. Fuck me, if this goes on like this, I will have to say my final verdict that this movie is pretty okay. In which case, I will commit ritual Japanese suicide. Instead of focusing on their goal, they crash a party. One of the special unit commando. They get introduced to a couple of women who want to blow their horns. But it turns out they are the wives of some of the dudes. And the woman claimed that they forced them. Are you trying to make good on what happened in the previous sequel? It kind of feels that way. Fuck you, you piece of shit. You are making me like you. But no, actually, this was all just a prank, and they don't get beaten up.
Yo, run your I'm joking! Stop!
How dare you? How dare you to play with my emotions like that? I hate you! Can we get back to the plot now? Oh yes, we can. At the party of the central committee for the opposing sports team that is going to play against their football team very soon, they do what they do best, being a nuisance. But for once in their lives, they actually do this for a purpose, because they suspect them to be responsible for the theft. Not some random fans, but the highest ops in the sports world. So this is what happens when they think. I mean, usually I am all for toppling the elites, but sometimes crimes of this magnitude do come from the street rather than the skyscrapers. But not often. They kidnap a guy only to discover that it's not the trainer of the other team they expected, but a comedic imitator. They call the guy from the hospital, who is the caretaker of the goat, and it's revealed that all the information they got was the result of a misunderstanding. Everything you saw was pointless, pointless, it was so pointless, pointless. In reality, the goat was in the guy's car all along, which is about to be squashed into a little cube at a dump. They crash the tractor and stop a woman in her car.
Hallo? Bin ich vielleicht zu schnell gefahren? Dann sollten Sie mich bestrafen.
The job on these streets is not for everyone. In case you missed what the joke was, it was actually porn. Aside from the fact that they haven't put up any roadblocks to prevent this exact thing from happening, what would have happened if they, you know, did some acting? Would they have been paid afterwards? That would have been the most amazing casual hitchhike in history. And the fact that I once again think about the practicalities in this situation reminds me what a disturbed person I am. Captain Dumb and his sidekick Not-So-Thinking-Fast-Boy barely escaped death, but eventually managed to save the mascot. They are saved a second time by the special commando after the macho dude finds out what happened to his car and wanted to make bacon out of them. They return the goat and the day is saved. When the other officer they don't like counts all their misdeeds, which he says are sure to get them fired, the commissioner interrupts and says, "Are you kidding? They brought a football mascot back. Who cares about a break-in, sexual harassment, speeding, and attempted murder?" It was in this moment that his belief in society crumbled and a new supervillain was born. Dr. Corp. The Cologne team wins the game, everybody gets drunk. The end. And that was Super Corp. This is going to be harder than I thought. Let me just come right out and say it, this movie is the best in the trilogy. That doesn't make it good, but it makes it decent enough. Most of the jokes are stuff you have seen a million times in comedies that came out 15 to 20 years earlier. But there are some jokes that have worked for about 10 seconds. If you exclude the fact that basically the entire journey was pointless, there are still some plot threads that go absolutely nowhere. Tommy and Mario are as unlikable as ever, but this stems mostly from my experience from before. If this had been my first encounter with them, I am sure I would find them only averagely annoying. They are bearable this time because the chaos they cause is mostly because of their dumbness and not their maliciousness, like before. Most of the time. And yes, I say the whole journey is pointless because unlike a movie like, say, Hangover, nothing of what they search for leads up to anything. It's just a whole series of jumping from one place to another. If I had to praise the movie in some way, I would say, to the movie's credit, this type of comedy has become extinct when it came out in 2011. So it is nice to have this kind of stuff again, just for a nostalgia tribute. The ending is infuriating. By just having this cosmic level of stupid all excused by a wave of your hand, and a cop who does everything right actually be punished in some way. Something that has happened so often in other movies of this kind and has over the years not become any less dumb. You broke the law? So what? We are the law! We can do whatever we want! Haha, corruption. All in all, the movie is forgettable, it's not my kind of humor, but even if it were, it would be just okay. Also, couldn't they have gotten any of the old main female characters back? Just for a quick cameo at least? The German guy out and auf Wiedersehen. We'll be right back.